Hey y'all, Kentucky Farmer here, and welcome back to the 23rd episode in this Pleasant Valley 17, FS17 Let's Play series. Last episode in this series, we bought some more equipment for down here at the cow farm, and we bought this field, well, I think we bought both of these fields in the last episode. And so we're going to continue getting these fields ready down here. My plan is to plant grass in both of them, but we need to plow this one over here. And then I'm probably going to do a round of oilseed radish on both of them just to get my initial fertilization done. So, kind of up here at the roadside overlook, which is a neat feature here in Pleasant Valley. So we'll head on down to the farm and get the T8. We'll get this thing out plowing field 28. Alright, and I'm just going to hire a worker, and we'll let it go. Looking good. And while that's going, I can start the seeder, planting oilseed radish over here on this field. And for this one, I'm just going to hire a worker, normal worker. Alright, there we go. Hope it is blocked by an object. I think that was me, so I'm not too worried about that. And next thing I'm going to do is grab the case with the stump grinder, and I'm going to cut this tree down, because I know this apparently triggers people to have a tree right here at the corner of the field. You know who you are. Alright, got the stump grinder, and we'll just have course play drive this down to the cow farm for us. So we'll do transfer farm to cows, drive course, and we will stop the last. And then I'll head back down to the farm and start cutting up that tree. Alright, get it back here. Our puma. Nice. And now we can send this back again. So we'll transfer cows to farm. And let's see, that combine's going to be in the way, so I need to figure out where that course is going. Guess I could send the combine back too. So we'll just do nearest waypoint, drive course, and stop it at the last point. And let's do the same thing with the combine. Transfer cows to farm. Nearest waypoint, drive course, stop at the last point. There we go. And as far as the stuff, we're just going to stack the firewood over here next to the shed. All right, we got a stack of firewood. That's kind of tedious, but honestly, I'm just kind of killing time here. I gotta get that, basically I gotta get an oilseed radish down on both these fields before I can advance time to the next day, and I really don't have anything else to do. Let's check out our growth stages here. Yeah, so you see all these, we're still waiting for them to come in. Nothing ready to harvest. Everything's pretty much fully fertilized. 5, 9, 20. We have oilseed radish. on those. Ditto for 25. So when we do actually seed those fields, they'll be fully fertilized. 11. We already put one stage fertilization on it. This growth cycle, we weeded it. I gotta wait for that to get to the next growth stage so that I can hit it with a sprayer. I could, in theory, plant something on 17, 18, or even 10, but I don't know. I'm still kind of just basically avoiding those fields. So I guess I'll hop up here and put this equipment away. No, you know what? I need this to put the header away. I'm getting a little low on fuel with this harvester, so might as well top it off here. Alright, put the harvester away. It's done refueling. Uh-oh, we ran out of fuel in the trailer. Well, I guess I can grab the semi and take that up to the gas station and refill it. Yeah, it looks like one of our helpers completed their task. Sorta completed your task? Alright, done with this field. And kinda wish that plow had a little bit bigger lead. One thing I was kind of thinking about doing, so I have a lot of grass up at the sheep area, like way more than those sheep are going to eat over the next couple of days. So I kind of think I'm going to run up there and grab a trailer load of it and bring it back down here so that I can throw it in the fermenter and start making silage. Oh, sorry, I have grass or hay up here. Yeah, alright, well, hay works too. Well, let's see, since this is hay, I'm gonna try. Not that it matters, I'm pretty sure this facility takes hay or grass. I'm gonna put this in here. And we're still waiting on that plow. So I think what I might do is drive up to the pig farm because I have a lot of straw in storage up at the pig farm. Again, more than those pigs are gonna need anytime soon. I mean, I have some in storage down here, but it's not nearly as much as I have up there by the pigs. And since I got a decent size truck and trailer here, might as well make the trip. Oh wow, yeah. 700,000 liters of straw. I think we can spare a trailer load or two from up here. Oh, you know what? I screwed up. I've been wanting to get rid of this water tanker that's up here and replace it with one that you can haul around with a tractor so that I don't have to bring a semi up here to refill the pig area. I should have moved this one down to the cow area and then bought a pull-behind version put up here instead. Man, I wish I would have remembered that. Oh well. Kind of thinking to get the fermenter running, one thing I could do is take the put this trailer behind the forage harvester with a dolly and then just drive around and mow free grass for a little bit and then dump that into the fermenter. I can probably move that forage harvester down to the cow area and just leave it down here. I think I need it for cotton and lavender. I'm not too sure if I have any of that planted right now. I think I do. But I can move it around as needed. It's pretty easy now that I got the course play transfer courses to bring stuff from the cow farm to the main farm and back again. So once I go dump this off, I'll set that up and have it drive down here. Probably still a little ways off from buying my first batch of cows, but might as well get the food production going here. Alright, let's get that forage harvester. It's group 3. Yep. We'll leave that header here. Whoops. Grab this header. And I'll go grab the dolly. That's not gonna fit in there. I'm gonna need a little bit of help. Alright, then we'll open up course play and we'll say transfer farm to cows. Drive course, stop blast. And we can head down and check on our plow, I guess. Probably still needs to get a little bit further before I start that cedar. That cedar goes fast, it'll catch up pretty quick. Let's see, we're done unloading straw. So we'll leave the trailer there. Alright, so I just gotta wait for the forage harvester to get here. There it is. Alright, stop the driver, clear the course. Get it hooked up to our trailer here. Right. Pipe out. Lower that. Turn that on. Yeah, we should be good to go. Alright, got one wagon load here. Let's see if I can. If I drop the header off, I think I can fit through here. Alright, and I'm gonna go start that cedar. Alright. So, probably gonna go out and do one more load of this. You know, since I gotta wait for the plowing the cedar to finish anyways, but driving around gave me a little time to think about this, and I think I know what I'm going to do with all those little fields that I'm not too sure what to do with, like 10, 17, 18, and eventually 21. I'm going to plant corn on them, and then I can just take this forage harvester with a trailer behind it like this and chaff it, and then use the chaff for silage production. So, because I'm not going to need a lot of chaff for a while until I get a ton of cows. And just rotating between those fields, I should like easily be able to make way more chaff than I need. So I think that's probably going to be what I'll do with them. I won't get to it in this episode. It'll probably be next episode. I'll seed one or two of those with corn. Not too sure if I can drive up this way. It's so high off the ground. Nope. I can only go one way on this. Alright, not the best placement in the world, but... not a big fan of the mod because it has something on three sides, so it makes it really hard to put it anywhere. I mean, really four if you consider that you have to drive in on this side. There we go. Alright, well, that's unloading. Grab this plow, get it out of the way. Forage harvester. I don't know why this thing's brake lights are still on. There we go. Alright, now we're just waiting on this guy. Looks like he's got one row left. Fantastic. Alright, that's going to wrap it up for this episode. We got oilseed radish planted on our two fields over here. We got a load of straw and hay in our forage mixer, and we got two loads of grass in the vertical fermenting silo getting ready. So after I get this field seeded here, I'm going to go ahead and fast forward time. And so next episode we will pick up on the next game day. And hopefully we'll have some... we're going to have a lot of fields that are ready to be seeded, that's for sure. Because we got a lot of oilseed radish out right now. Maybe we'll have something ready to harvest. We'll see. So, thanks for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this episode. If you did, would you please give it a thumbs up? That helps a lot. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. And if you haven't already, please subscribe for more Farming Simulator videos. I'm Kentucky Farmer. Thanks for watching.